Getting lost in unusual locations. The mission objectives of the James Webb Space Telescope, the long-awaited successor to the Hubble Space Telescope, are not the plot of a new science fiction film for the next decade, but rather the study of the universe's beginnings and the search for life on other planets. The Webb Telescope, built by NASA, will be the world's most powerful space science observatory, capable of studying every phase of cosmic history. According to a new study, dark matter could be made up of ancient black holes, which explores an old theory that has lately been resurrected. A new telescope that was just deployed may even clarify the gravitational influence of dark matter. According to Benjamin Laman, a physicist and PhD candidate at the University of Santa Cruz who studies dark matter and is a particle physics researcher who is not involved in the research, many particle physics models use what are known as weakly interacting massive particles, which are heavy, slow-moving theoretical particles that pull on the conventional matter via gravity. But that explanation has been increasing tension with recent experimental data. Researchers didn't have a true sense of scale when Hawking postulated primordial black holes, so the James Webb Telescope will look at signals from more than 13.5 billion years ago in new models, which could offer a link between Hawking's decades-old hypothesis and dark matter. Because passengers expected the black holes developed would be very small, scientists searched for gamma rays produced by minuscule black holes in the years that followed. When they couldn't find any, most researchers shelved the idea for decades. On December 25, 2021, NASA launched the James Webb Space Telescope, which will supersede the famed Hubble Telescope as the agency's new flagship astrophysics operation. The telescope will have more resolution and sensitivity than its predecessor. Researchers have suggested that the James Webb Space Telescope could allow scientists to study some of the universe's most distant events and objects, such as the formation of the first galaxies, by allowing them to investigate one of Stephen Hawking's most controversial theories, which was first proposed in the 1970s that the invisible substance dark matter could play a role in the formation of the first galaxies. On January 8th, the James Webb Space Telescope crew completed the deployment of the telescope's 21-foot primary mirror, marking a major mission milestone. At this point, all major spacecraft deployments required to prepare for science operations had been performed successfully. The optics of the telescope would then be aligned by shifting the 18 primary mirror segments, which would take months to complete. The James Webb Space Telescope will investigate the strangely flashing black hole at the heart of our galaxy, the Milky Way, which has eluded previous telescopes. But what do you know? In April 2019, a group of more than 200 scientists from around the world released the first image of a black hole. The Event Horizon Telescope, or EHT, was deployed by a variety of radio telescopes to view the black hole at the galaxy's center. 87 Messier. During a 7-day span, the EHT team used data from 8 telescopes on 5 continents to construct the image. M87 is 55 million light-years away from Earth and has a mass 6.5 billion times that of the Sun, making it far larger than Sagittarius. A celebrity Webb will work with a number of telescopes to better understand the nature of Sagittarius, a star that is a supermassive black hole whose inclination to flare at an hourly rate makes imaging difficult. Scientists have never personally seen Sagittarius as a star, but they know it exists because of its influence on the surroundings. For example, the star S02 is on a 16-year elliptical orbit around the black hole plasma, or murky ionized gas. According to Webb officials in late 2021, M87's core presented a steady target, while M87's core presented a significantly more difficult target. With its own infrared images of the black hole zone, Sagittarius A+ exhibits odd flickering flares on an hourly basis, making the photography process much more challenging. Flares occur when charged particles are driven to greater energy surrounding the black hole, resulting in light emission. The site will provide data on when flares are present, which will be beneficial to the EHT team. Because EHT is on the ground, the expectation is that the information obtained from the web will complement the ground-based network data, resulting in a cleaner, easier-to-understand image. The Webb, which was launched on December 25th and is currently undergoing a month-long commissioning process, will eventually image Sagittarius A+ in two infrared wavelengths from a perch in deep space free of stray light. The James Webb Telescope observes the universe in two infrared wavelengths, F210m and F480m, at the same time. The telescope is also positioned to provide a continuous view of Sagittarius, a star, during both its flaring and tranquil periods. Webb will be perched on a perch around 1 million kilometers from the Earth at Lagrangian point 2, L2, a gravitationally stable location. The L2 orbit ensures that it will always be facing away from the Sun, sheltering it from the star's light and heat. The JWST's orbit also keeps it out of the shadows of both the Earth and the Moon, giving it an unobstructed view of the universe for the duration of its journey. Meanwhile, every 90 minutes, the Hubble Space Telescope passes through the shadow of the Earth, and the Webb and other telescopes will use multi-wavelength studies of Sagittarius, a star, to aid scientists' understanding. One thing scientists don't know about Sagittarius is the dynamics that govern these cosmic critters. The flares are caused by a star, and scientists will be able to see how they peak and fade away. This will help them not only with their research into black holes, but also with their understanding of the Sun and its outbursts. It's a process, according to Markov. Yes, collaborators expect Webb and EHT to come together and provide more information about what causes flares, which could lead to new insights into black holes, solar flares, and particle and plasma physics. We want to know how the universe works in general because we are a part of it. Some of these major questions may be answered by black holes, according to primary investigator Fahad Yousefzader's study. According to the news release, the first actual black hole was discovered in 1971, and the first EHT photograph of the M87 star in 2019 provided clear visible verification that Einstein's black hole prediction was correct. The scientists went on to say that black holes serve as a proving ground for Einstein's theory, and that this first collaboration between the Webb and EHT will allow for more telescope time. Black holes, according to Einstein's general theory of relativity, are the densest, most densely packed locations of matter known, rather than an empty hole in space. A black hole's gravitational pull is so strong that it warps the fabric of space around it, trapping any material that approaches too close, as well as any light it emits forever, which is why black holes appear black. The event horizon is the name given to the multimate inner boundary of that light by scientists, and it is from this that the EHT collaboration gets its name. Telescopes detect light from the area surrounding the black hole, not from the black hole itself. That's it for today. Thank you for watching. Please leave us your valuable feedback, and if you found the video interesting, stay tuned for the next video. Until then, see you soon. This is Tech Revelations once again.